Welcome to Daily Steps from One Extraordinary Marriage, where we outline simple steps that you can take to have the ultimate marriage adventure. I'm Tony DeLorenzo, your co-host, along with my beautiful wife, Elisa. In today's show, we answer the question, how do I get my husband to wear his wedding ring?
My husband and I have been married for 5 years. He's never worn a wedding ring. I've asked numerous times and bought him a few different types of rings so that he can wear them on the job. And when he doesn't use his job as an excuse, he just says it feels weird.
So I got a question though, real quick. On their wedding day, aren't the bands exchanged and wouldn't he have put it on then?
Well, I don't know. She didn't actually say if they exchanged rings as part of their ceremony.
Gotcha.
So
okay.
Traditionally, that's part of the wedding ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if he has a ring that he's just never worn. I mean, obviously he's got a few different mm-hmm. rings that he's not worn.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we actually encountered this in a season of our own marriage, right? Where you were working at a job where the ring you... Okay, actually, I want you to share this. What happened to your first wedding ring?
Yeah, so it was about at that time we'd been married, 2 years?
Mm-hmm.
And had gone to work in a trade. And so I was there and it was just one of those things that my wedding band, for me at that time, felt awkward with what I was doing. It bothered me. I honestly couldn't get it off my finger. And it has on the inside of it, it has a beveled edge. Because I'm feeling it right now as I'm talking. It had a bevel edge, but I couldn't get it off. And I felt like my fingers were getting swollen by the end of the day and it was just hurting. So I actually was in the shop and we had a grinder and my shop foreman helped me grind off my wedding band.
It was a great day when Tony comes home and puts his sawed in half wedding ring on the table. And it's like, I'm not going to be wearing my wedding ring for a while. I'm like, what? But there are a few different things to actually look at.
Not a good move now that I look back 20 years.
Yeah, you could have handled that
one differently. I probably could have handled that much different. So I understand it from a work situation. And yet I think nowadays though, there are so many different varieties, especially the silicone rings that mm-hmm. we know a lot of our folks who are in the emergency services,
right.
Firefighters, firewomen, you know, any of those folks that will use those silicone rings. Back in the day, 20 years ago, we didn't have those. I have since, and I will say this, I have since gone back. I had it mended and made right, and I wear it.
And we actually had new wedding rings created for our 20th wedding anniversary. So
yes.
He's got a couple of rings to wear, depending
yes,
on,
I do.
On how the mood fits. But to address this, you know, it really goes back to, you know, creating that emotional intimacy on what are the expectations for the ring,
mm-hmm.
right? What does it mean to the two of you as a couple? And you know, what does it mean to him? What does it mean to you? And to look at this and say, okay, what's behind not wearing the ring? You know, actually, I read this question the first time when it came in. My thought was, did he see his dad wear a ring? You know, because for a lot of us, how we show up in our marriages and the things that we do and the patterns of behavior are very much because of what we saw modeled. So if dad didn't wear a ring, maybe that's why he's not wearing a ring.
Mm-hmm. I will say, though, my dad always wore his ring.
Mm-hmm.
My dad wore his ring on his dying bed. I mean, my dad always wore his ring. So that was all me, just FYI.
And it's also looking at what else is going on in the marriage. Like, again, getting into that emotional intimacy. Some people just don't feel comfortable wearing jewelry. There mm-hmm. are lots of men that don't feel comfortable wearing jewelry. What's the dynamic between the two of you? What are the conversations that you're having around this? Does he feel pressured to wear the ring? And you know, some people, when they feel pressured, will actually run in the opposite direction.
I know other guys and women as well, who have tattooed
mm-hmm.
a ring on that finger.
We have a number of friends who have tattooed rings,
mm-hmm.
right? And so it's looking at, you know, let's start exploring the options. I get it. Maybe it just feels uncomfortable. All good.
Let's come up with the solutions now. And again, what are the expectations around that ring? What does it mean? And what can we do together? What's mm-hmm. the solution we can find? Instead of you being aggravated with him and maybe upset with him for not wearing it, what are some solutions that you guys can come up together? You know, again, right now, we're in a day and age where if it's saying like it doesn't feel good, I'm telling you, there are so many people out there that make custom rings mm-hmm. that are absolutely amazing that will customize it to you. So you don't have to go into just some store and pick up some 14 karat gold ring and be like, well, that's the one, that's the band. I know for some guys that is an issue. It's like, it's just a 14 karat gold band. I wear mine. I like it, but I also have, and Elisa does as well, we have custom made ones. Mm-hmm. We have a couple of them. And so it may be like, hey, you know what? I just want something that really represents who I am and who we are mm-hmm. in our marriage. So, or again, it may be the work thing where it's like, hey, can we just get you a silicone one? I mean, you can find those on Amazon. They're everywhere. I mean, Qualo's one of the companies I know of. There's some others. So check those out. But again, let's find a solution and come up with a way for both of you to be on that same page.
Mm-hmm. It's really getting into this place of how do the two of you handle this as a couple, right? This isn't something that he has to do or something that you have to nag him on, but rather it's saying, this is just one thing in marriage, right? But you guys have only been married 5 years. We've been married 22 years. There are going to be things over the lifetime of your marriage. What are the things that you really need to fight for? And what are the things that with understanding, you're like, you know what? That one's not such a big deal.
Do you want your question answered? Send an email to dailysteps@oneextraordinarymarriage.com and put the subject line, Daily Steps Question.